Educational Service Limited. Today is for mathematics class. And today's topic we want to treat is coordinate geometry. Coordinate geometry. Coordinate geometry, as written on the board, this is used to study the properties of a coordinate. And the coordinate is always represented in a plane form, as written as x, comma y. Where this s, we call it abscissa, and y, we call it ordinate. So the combination of x, comma y, we call it coordinate. So this is the way of representing a particular coordinate in the sense that we have the x and we have the y. So x here represents abscissa and y is ordinate. Which simply means if you are given something like 2, comma 3, we reverse this as x axis, y this one is y axis. This x axis we call it abscissa, y this one we call it ordinate. So the combination of them we call it coordinate. So one of the aspects of what mathematics that deal with the properties of a coordinate is what we reverse as coordinate geometry. Here, we are interested in the volumes. In this coordinate geometry, we are interested, one, how to determine the distance between 2 points. At the end of the class, you must be able to identify the difference between the volume. One, distance between 2 points. Distance between 2 points. Distance between 2 points. Two, we have division of a line. Division of a line. Using ratio end to end. Using ratio end to end. Three, you must be able to know how to determine the midpoint of a line. Midpoint of a line. Four, you must be able to identify the equation of a straight line. Actually, there are three forms of equation of a straight line, but you must be able to identify the difference between them. Straight line. We have angle between angles between two lines. After the angle between two lines, we have distance of a straight line. Distance of a straight line from origin. Likewise, we have distance of a straight line from the external point. Distance of a straight line from external point. Distance of a straight line from external point. Those are the interesting things that we must be able to identify the difference between them. Under this coordinate geometry, the distance between 2 points, the vision of a line using ratio end to end, the midpoint of a line, the equation of a straight line, angle between two lines, distance of a straight line from the origin, and the distance of a straight line from the external point. At the end of the class, you must be able to identify the difference between these terms. You must be able to know how to calculate the formula to calculate the distance between 2 points. You must be able to know how to calculate the division of the line using ratio end to end. You must be able to determine the midpoint of the line. You must be able to understand the equation of the straight line, angle between two lines, distance of the straight line from the origin, and the distance of the straight line from the external point. So let's start from the first one, distance between 2 points. How do you determine the distance between 2 points? If you have 2 points, and it's representing in terms of the coordinates, we have a point A which contains its own coordinates, and a point B which contains other coordinates. But we want to determine the distance between the point A and point B. The formula to be used can be deduced as follows. So distance between 2 points. Distance between 2 points. Distance between 2 points. So this is the first one. We want to interest us to explain. The distance between 2 points. Suppose I have 2 points. Suppose I have a point A which contains the coordinate x1, y1, and I have another point B which contains x2, y2. Then the distance between the point A and point B, I've written as d, which is equal to the distance AB, and it can be written in this form as the square root of x2 minus x1 raised to the power 2 plus y2 minus y1 raised to the power 2. So by the time you observe this, this is the formula for calculating distance. I can call it equation 1. The distance between the point A and point B. I subtract the abscissor, x2 minus x1 raised to power 2. Then I subtract the ordinate, y2 minus y1 raised to power 2. You may be interested that how this formula was obtained. How do you got the formula? So the formula can be deduced as follows. So for me to prove this formula, I can just consider a plane surface. I consider a plane surface because you will have seen we have two coordinates here, which is the x-axis and the y-axis. So we consider a plane surface. I consider a plane surface. Consider a plane surface. As shown in the diagram below, consider this plane surface. This is the plane surface. And eventually, I can call this place, this is the y-axis. And this place here is what? X-axis. If there's a particular point, let me call it point A, which contains x1, y1. If you have another point here, let me call it point B, which contains x2, y2 as the line of. So now, for me to get the distance between the point A to point B, I can represent this by D, which is the same as distance AB. So if this place is D, and eventually I can decide to trace this, I trace the horizontal axis, I put trace the vertical axis, and I believe at this point there is value of x. At this point, there is value of x. The value of x at this point is x2. And the value of x at this point is what? x1. The value of y at this point is what? y1. While the value of y here is what? y2. For you to get the distance from this point to this point, you can just call this point point C, which simply means there is distance AC and there is distance BC. The distance BC will be equal to y2 minus y1. While the distance between C and A will be x2 minus what? x1. So if this place here is y2 minus y1, this will be x2 minus x1. So from this diagram, if I remove the right angle triangle that is here, because this has 90 degrees, so if you remove the right angle triangle out, you have something of this form. This is what we have here. This place here is distance BC, and this place here, the distance A to B. A to B represented by D. The distance between BC is y2, minus y1, and the distance between AC is x2 minus x1, and this is at right angle. And remember, the right angle triangle, Pythagoras theorem is applicable, which states that the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of two other sides. So if I use Pythagoras theorem here, I can say hypotenuse square is equal to opposite square plus the hypotenuse square. So this is what we have here. Your hypotenuse side for this problem is what? Is D. Any side that makes right angle is called hypotenuse. Any side that fails the angle, we call it opposite, and the remaining one is adjacent side. Well, here there is no specified angle. The only one we have here is angle 90 degrees, which indicates the hypotenuse side. So any of these two sides can serve as opposite and what? Adjacent side. So hypotenuse square, our hypotenuse here is what? Is D. So I have D raised to power 2 equal to, we have the next one. The next one is opposite square. I can say this is y2 minus y1, or you look at x. Plus x2 minus x1 square. So if you look at it, this place is this square. I can write this one because alphabetically it's coming forward. Can I write this as x2 minus x1 raised to power 2 plus y2 minus y1 raised to power 2. So if I decide to cancel this square, Mr. Square and Mr. Square will be a hanging. So for you to cancel the Mr. Square, you can take Mr. Square root to both sides. So if I take square root, I declare a statement square root to both sides of the equation. Take square root of both sides of the equations. What are we going to have? It implies that our this place is what? The square root of this square will now be called what? The square root of x2 minus x1 raised to power 2 plus y2 minus y1 raised to power 2. This and this will go. D will be equivalent to the square root of x2 minus x1 raised to power 2 plus y2 minus y1 raised to power 2. So, we can just conclude that in conclusion, the distance between the point, two points, is given as the square root of x2 minus x1 raised to power 2 plus y2 minus y1 raised to power 2. I can decide to start this. This is already what? Proved. You can see from the work, from the beginning, that the distance between the points A and B are listed as x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. Through the proving, you can be able to observe that and observe at the end that this time between the point has been derived and the formula is x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. So, without any disturb, it is very, very easy to generate if you didn't remember the formula. But the fact is that the formula is even easy for you to put into the memory. Just note that the distance between the two points A and B can be determined by using x2 minus h1 square plus y2 minus y1 square. Now to explain the point from here, I draw the diagrams y and x axis. I pick a point A to the ordinate of s1, y1, and the point B is s2, y2. As you can see, if I set this one to be point C, I believe that there is a value of x here. The value of x at this axis is x1, while the value of x at this point is x2. The value of y here is y1, while the value of y at this ordinate is y2. For me to get the distance between these two points, I will say y2 minus y1. The distance between this one is what? S2 minus s1. Then after doing that, I observe that there is a particular right angle triangle, which indicates that the distance AB has determined is what I put here. The distance between BC has determined as y2 minus y1, while this place is x2 minus s1. So using Pythagoras theorem, you observe that we have d squared equal to s2 minus s1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. We are taking the square root to both sides in order to cancel the Mr. Square. Because Mr. Square and Mr. Square root, they are in it. On doing that, you observe that d equals s2 minus s1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared. That's the formula. Let's sensitize this with example. But I'm interested in sensitizing this one with example. Something that is not difficult, but rather requires some explanations. So let's see how we can go with example. For example, if I want to determine it, I can say question one. Find the distance between two points A, we have a point 2, 3, and B, we have the point 3, 5. That's a big question. The point A is minus 1, 2, and the second point B is minus 3, -5. Our question C, the point A is 1, 4, and another point D is equal to 2, 5. The distance.